It's Sybil Wilkes with What You Need to Know. Today is Thursday, May 13th, 2021. The presiding judge in last month's trial of Derek Chauvin in the murder of George Floyd has ruled that prosecutors proved Chauvin's cruelty beyond a reasonable doubt. Among the four aggravated factors, Judge Cahill stated, the white former Minneapolis police officer abused his position of authority and treated George Floyd with particular cruelty. How much time will the judge give Chauvin? Sentencing is now scheduled for June 25th. Number two, tensions were high this week as the Senate Rules Committee debated a comprehensive election law, the For the People Act, that was introduced by Democrats. Republicans fought back against virtually every aspect of the bill, painting the legislation as an attempted takeover of elections by Democrats. The panel was able to adopt some changes to the package, including a provision allowing mail-in voting for service members and options for voters with disabilities to return their ballots. Number three, the number of new COVID-19 cases continues to fall in the United States. However, outbreaks continue to grow in other countries, particularly in India. This week, World Health Organization officials announced that it is reclassifying the highly contagious variant from India as a variant of concern, signaling it has become a global health threat. Number four, the NFL has looked to HBCUs in the past as a source of talent, but in more recent years, players at our schools have been cut out. This year, out of the 259 picks chosen, not one player from a historically black college or university was selected in the 2021 draft. NFL Hall of Famer and current head coach for Jackson State University, Deion Sanders, vented on Instagram, saying he has seen HBCU players who were more than qualified to be drafted. Number five, Apple has promised to add 20,000 U.S. jobs by the year 2026, with at least 3,000 of those jobs being in Raleigh, North Carolina. The Research Triangle Park in Raleigh gives Apple access to talent at HBCUs Shaw University and North Carolina Central University. The opportunity would align with Apple's active efforts to attract black tech talent through its Apple HBCU Scholars Program. Here's your daily inspiration from Yogi's Jewels. You are responsible for bringing good energy into this world. All right, count me in. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central with George Wallace and our very special guest, the wonderful Kenny Lattimore, as we discuss today's top headlines and more. Thank you to our What You Need to Know partners, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated, and Black Voters Matter. To subscribe to my free daily newsletter, please visit SybilWilkes.com. Be informed, be empowered.